Welcome back to BNG Hockey, where it's always black and gold. With the 21st pick in the 2021 NHL Draft, the Boston Bruins are proud to select Fabian Lysell. Let's talk about it. Fabian Lysell is a 5'10", 172-pound right-shot right winger. Last season in the SHL, he played in 26 games, scoring 2 goals, 1 assist for a total of 3 points. But don't let those stats scare you away from this player. We're going to get into a lot of the reasons why this was a great pick, but first off, I want to give you the rest of the stats. He actually ended up moving on to a different team to play bigger minutes against older players. But against guys his own age, the stats are a lot better. In 11 games, he had 3 goals, 10 assists, and a total of 13 points. And the season prior to that, against guys his own age, he played in 14 games, scoring 13 goals, 21 assists, for a total of 34 points. Now, I know the stats don't look great, but you have to remember, these players are so young and are continuing to develop. And it can be hard for these teenagers to put up stats against older players. But once he gets a little bit bigger, a little bit stronger, a little bit faster, a little bit more skilled, something's going to click, and the stats are going to start coming to back up how good this player actually is. This is a guy with a ton of upside, not afraid to shoot the puck, really drives play, is a fantastic skater, and projects to be a star in this league, and definitely a top 6 winger. And I know a lot of Bruins fans always complain about the Bruins picks, but one of the biggest complaints is picking guys who are way off the board and guys who project to be nothing more than a middle 6 player. A guy like a Trent Frederick, a Zach Senyshyn, maybe even a John Beecher, it's not looking like he's going to be a top 6 guy. So you can't complain about that and then turn around and complain that the Bruins picked somebody with this much upside. He was listed as a top 10 player in most mock drafts and at least a top 15 player in most mock drafts. So it's great to get him at pick 21. That's an absolute steal, and this player is going to keep getting better and be a great pick for the Bruins. So now let's talk about how the Bruins got so lucky. How were they able to steal this kid at 21 when he was rated as a top 10 pick? Well, the biggest reason, the way they described it at least, was that there was some concerns about his character. But once I did a little bit of a deeper dive and hearing Don Sweeney talk about it, I really don't think that will be a problem. At first, I got really nervous. It immediately made me think of Tyler Seguin. One of the biggest reasons he was moved out of here was because they didn't love his personality and his character, so I was worried about them picking this player and maybe getting frustrated with him later down the line. But as I said, hearing Don Sweeney's comments and further investigating, it seems like teams were really concerned that he asked to change teams in the middle of the season, but that was really due to playing time, so I don't have too much of a problem with that. And watching some of his highlights, it seems like his biggest character flaw is that maybe he's a little cocky. He scored a great goal. He kind of gave the quiet down to the crowd celebration, putting a finger to his mouth. Seems like maybe he sees himself as an absolute stud already. And maybe as he starts to see that it's getting harder playing against older players, he's not so great. He still has work to do. So maybe some teams were concerned about that. But honestly, he kind of reminds me of a David Pastrnak. He was talking about how good he looks in his suit. He was talking about how he's a good player. He's very confident. He's definitely had plenty of highlight reel plays and enough skill to back it up. But with a little bit of work, he can take that confidence and become a star. So I'm really not worried about it. If that's a reason to fall, there are plenty of worse reasons for a player to fall in the draft. I think it's a great pick for the Bruins. As I've said before, we need top-end talent. That's why I was so happy that we brought Taylor Hall back. But once we lose guys like Marchand and Bergeron, we're going to need some top-six help. And this is one of the best prospects the Bruins have, by far, right out of the gate. And he's only getting better. All in all, I'm extremely happy with this pick. I know it can be concerning at times when Don Sweeney's going up to the mic to make a pick. He's definitely been known to reach, definitely been known to draft for need instead of best available, but they didn't do that here, and they definitely did their homework on this kid. PJ Axelsson has been keeping a close eye on him, scouting him over in Sweden. Don Sweeney really likes him. He even talked about potentially moving up to get this player and how lucky they were to get an impact guy at pick 21. So he did the opposite of what he normally does. He picked the best player available, and he stole him because this was a guy who was ranked a lot higher. So that was great to see. This is a guy with so much upside. It's a guy that the NHL analysts said could be a star in this league, so that's very exciting if you're a Bruins fan. Welcome to Boston, Fabian. Can't wait to see you in the black and gold. Let me know your thoughts on this pick down below in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a big like. And if you're looking forward to more recaps from the rest of the draft from me, make sure you subscribe.